Nice, that's really good. Come on. Amazing. Amazing. Great, amazing. Oh, give me more biotin, jeez, please. I love getting absolutely fucked by RNG. That's all I do. Thank you. Yeah. Yo, so kind. ¿Qué pasa, tío? Welcome. Bienvenido. Doing alright, man. Just being unlucky. That's all. How are you, man? Doing good? No. I am not world record and I don't have world record either. But I don't care. I just don't really have the time or will to grind for world record, I don't really care. If it happens, it happens, but I don't really care. That's not why I speedrun. Okay, good. What are you doing lately, man? It's different. The thing is, they're just completely different games. Like, yeah, sure, they are both action RPGs, but the way they are done are very different. So they cater different kind of aspects, and there's different people, I guess, as well. But, you know, for me, different aspects of gameplay. And in some aspects it's better, but it, in some other aspects it's better. It's worse, you know. I would say this though. Right now, at this precise moment, Neo 2 is better made. It's more finished, so to speak. This one still needs a bit more cooking. It doesn't have the DLCs, still lacks some patches, some more fixes and tweaks. So yeah. Ah, come on, bro. What am I doing? Not bad. Getting really unlucky with this guy now, this tiger. Like, tonight I haven't gotten a single good fight on him, I think. But yeah, I guess in some aspects, the game is not as good as I thought it was gonna be. But not like the actual game aspects, it's more like certain things, certain issues beyond the gameplay that are kind of like annoying. I remember this fucking piece of shit. Yo, the Fraganza, welcome. Remember to check out the rules. Very important. Come on. Get the thing, thank you. Yeah, I remember, like, I showed this song to my family, like, this last Christmas. Last Christmas. And my mother and sister liked the start, but then as soon as Nujabes started singing, they didn't like that. For whatever reason, it's like, bro, that's literally the best part of it. Yeah. Tastes. Not been working about it, I guess. Black, welcome. Yeah. Also check out the rules. You guys are forgetting to check out the rules. Very important. Sub 15, by the way, for the first time on Fire Spam. Just saying. I got pretty close earlier. I was streaming on Kick, but didn't actually get there because of shenanigans.
また入りようこの方は当た一流でもよかったらそれここでの仕事いや調子はどうだい また入りようがあったら遠慮なく言ってよね
Yeah. going on. That was sketchy, but yeah, not too slow. Shall we get the sub 20 Manosenki? Foggies? Question mark? They try. They really fucking tried. I hadn't got it and gotten that RNG before. Wow. Everything is just really going against me. Nice. Come on, finally I get a good run going. For now, of course, for now. Waiting for, tell me what you're waiting for. Of course. Man, this is so fucking random whether you get like a decent fight or not. Yeah, it's very cool, fucking trash panda notification or little pop-up, whatever. Very cool bang. I got the second fight that was actually good, but not great. Shit, I hate that. I was doing something else, and it's just like, oh man. Yo, QWERTY. Welcome. WSG. Run was going good up until this point. Then it became not good. Or not so good. This mission, or you know, battlefield, whatever. Get that. Oh, man. Wow. How the fuck did I not die? How the fuck did I not die? I was completely sure I was gonna die right there. Yeah, it goes beyond that though. It goes beyond that. There's a lot of RNG. You can get absolutely fucked by like playing the same amount of level. Like, just don't make any big mistake or anything like that. And you get absolutely fucked, or you can also just get like a completely super easy fight because of the RNG. And also there's a lot of input reading in this game as well. Like in certain situations you literally just know that the game just read what you were about to do and just decide to do one action in order to prevent you from actually winning. Sure. At one point, somehow, I didn't die. But man, the input reading and situation change, like the AI changes their pattern depending on the situation. They will hard fucking they will hard stop you from doing like a fatal strike or something like that. Like they will do everything they can in order to stop you from doing a fatal strike to an enemy. It's ridiculous sometimes, I swear. Like how much they change their pattern in order to do that. Yeah. Made this no, I disagree with that. Like, you gotta realize that this game has nothing to do with Souls games. Or Neo, like, I'm sure it has some certain stuff that are just like Neo. But gameplay-wise, no, not really. Well, I guess they're preventing you from, like, punishing certain things was present in Neo. But, yeah, not the main parts, you know, not the main things. Because it really doesn't play anything like a Souls game, so... Yeah, the thing is, Sekiro is often called a Souls-like, but the only reason why it's called a Souls-like is because the same company, or you know, the same dev team that made Dark Souls and Bloodborne and whatnot also made Sekiro. But it's a very different game. You can, it's like in the same way that you can smell, you can, or you can see, you can appreciate how the same devs that were involved in Neo 1 and Neo 2 made this game, and you can see that also that there's some ideas from the producer of Bloodborne and whatnot. Look at this cover. Like for example, this shit right here, the thing that I'm switching, that is a complete downgrade compared to Neo. Neo's item system was way better, But you know, they dumped it down on petition of the Bloodborne producer. For some reason, they agreed on doing it like that. When it's like way less useful, but you know, whatever. Yeah, yeah, of course, like the depths of this game are great, but they also have some quick things going on. Like some really weird things, or really weird decisions, so to speak. Being a Dark Bakula, is it like this? Oh man. The lock-on system has improved, but it's still really fucking messy. Really fucking messy, and you can tell with the multiple enemies situations. It, like, the lock-on just doesn't know what to do. It starts going like apeshit. It's just weird. Yeah, see what I mean? Like, it's impossible to do certain things. You're just trying to do one thing and then you just keep interrupting you all the time. Like, they don't let you do anything. And that's just RNG. This other time is just PCs at the start. Like, you just do everything the same way, but then you get different results. Because why not? Yeah, that was incredibly messy, but I had to do it like that. Yeah, because of the stupid NPC invasions. For whatever reason they said, oh yeah, let's just have NPC invasions. Fun. I don't like that either. Yo, Eric, I don't know. What do you think about the race? You know, I was literally just waiting for you to pop in or to talk about the race.
Yeah.
asshole. Man. Yeah, I mean, it depends on the NPC. Only gripe is that the sand penalty could have been nullified due to the botched restart. Yeah, and for whatever reason, they didn't feel like backing off on that decision. Honestly, the way I see things, I think when there's like only less than 10 laps after a red flag, they should just do a not a standing start, you know, a launch restart instead. Something like that. I wonder what the okay, let's just see that if you think the same thing as I think. What do you think is the first thing that they should worry about? Like the first thing that they should upgrade on Aston Martin in order to be more competitive? You know, or higher on the competition. Yeah, I would say that is true, Rerik. Oh, did you watch the F2 race? Because I happened to wake up early enough to, like, I went to sleep pretty early, and then I just suddenly woke up at like 3:15, and I was like, okay, right now at 3:30, there's the F2 race. I'm gonna just watch it because I've already woke up already. So I may as well do that. So I did that. Come on, what is it? This is not good. I think, so what I was thinking actually was, it was not exactly that. I was more in the thought of, oh, really? I'm just gonna do that, huh? I was more in the thought that they should make the DRS better, like their DRS better. fuck me, man. Because I think that's the worst thing that they have. The DRS is really not effective for them compared to the rest. Yeah, but that is what I mean. Like they need to upgrade the DRS in the sense that they need to improve how much the DRS benefits from the rest. Like for example, have you seen the? I'm guessing you have seen the thing about the Red Bull's DRS, right? Like triple DRS kind of stuff. Like the rest of the car is just made in a way that. Makes it so the you get more benefit from the DRS. That's really good. That's a really good fight. Happy? I love how like the game can show you the prompt to skip the cutscene, and then also is this a little fight? I mean, that's what happens when you play better, it becomes easier, right? But yeah, what I was saying, what the, man, yo, Anaba Rex, the welcome. Remember to check the rules. Every time one recommendation, every time that you're new to a stream, remember to check out the rules. But yeah, what I was saying. So yeah, like the fight just becomes easier as a result, right? When you get that. Yeah, I was thinking about that as well, Eric. But again, like you saw how two things. One, the Mercedes has a better DRS advantage, and two, they were stronger slightly stronger, at least in Melbourne. So yeah. Race pace, they were very similar, I would say. But they were also, I think, warming up the tires faster. So the Astons struggling more with keeping up the temperature up, like at the start. Yeah. Dark Polax plus 3? What? I have to check that one. Minus 420. Nice. Man, imagine if I didn't get screwed on the... on those two missions. Two battlefields, whatever. But yeah, I mean, it's also like the idea of, okay, how much potential does the car have left? You know what I mean? Like, how much can you squeeze the like more performance with the same kind of car concept, like how, you know, how much you can include new pieces in order to upgrade the car without changing the base, which is what apparently like Mercedes was thinking about, but then suddenly they just were super competitive here, like not here, but you know, on Melbourne. So, 5-colored casual run. I'm gonna try to do a run with every weapon type at some point, but I'm not gonna say when because it depends on many factors. Because I have like a list of things to do, basically. Sorry. There's only a list of things to do, but there are other things that are before that as well. Yeah, probably, Eric. Because they didn't change anything, at least nothing fundamental. They didn't give an actual upgrade at any point. Every run planned? Not every run planned, I just have ideas. I have plans of doing things, But the runs themselves are not planned. Let's just say that after any percent, if I'm happy with an any percent run that I do, I'll just start doing either level 1 any percent or all battle flags. I'm probably more curious about all battle flags first, actually. I'll probably do that first and then do the other thing. But yeah, if you pay attention to my runs, like both, you know, official or actual category on the speedruns for Neo 2, Neo 1 as well, but especially Neo 2, and then also the meme and challenge runs that I've done, you can see there's somewhat of a pattern. I'm gonna follow a similar pattern to that, basically. It's not gonna be exact, obviously, because it depends on what I feel like at the moment as well, but yeah. Man, I need to not use that there. Well, I mean, this is basically like the most optimal weapon using the run. It just also happens to be one of the slowest. Was the fastest? You can see it right there. You see the time, what it says OIC. That's the final split. And the time is my PB. Fast. I mean, it's pretty fast, but I'm aiming for quite a bit faster than that, honestly. Oh, I see. Then. Yeah, good. Matter the race yesterday, I had a thought. Think about the beat 2021. Hindsight was even reflect when Latifi crashed. Yeah. Yeah, I agree. Should have been a red flag for sure. Because then everyone would have gotten like actual, you know, if they were wanted to have like an actual race, fair race at the end, and just made the best win. Which, by the way, Hamilton was gonna win, like, and not by a little bit, like quite a bit. But you know, they just say that, you know, you cannot obviously maintain that difference, so you need to kind of try to minimize the damage that the crash has made to the competition, right? At least that's what I think. So a red flag is definitely definitely would have helped. But I don't know, in my opinion, I think situations like that should be red flagged and then done instead of like a standing start, just a flying start or running start or whatever. Because that way I think it's more spectacular when it's like a standing start, but it's also like when there's so little amount of laps left, it's just kind of making the rest of the race less, you know what I mean? I think at some point they should just kind of like try to prevent that from happening, you know, like from damaging the actual race. I'm not saying that they should just red flag into standing, rolling stars, sorry, every time, but I think in situations like that, it's just better. Okay, see ya, Quartic. Thank you for stopping by. But not double file rolling, just like the usual ones that they do. Because the thing is, like, the double file rolling restarts, it's viable there because they have the space for that every time, you know. But here is just different. F1 is different. Yeah, I mean, in my opinion, like, it's okay to just do like another restart, so to speak, like a standing start, if it's not near the end. I mean, it depends on how conservative you can do it, like you can do 50, 60, 70, 80% maybe. And then past that, you just do rollings and not a standing starts, just to not like kind of throw everything else to the garbage, so to speak, you know. But yeah, it's always like a takeaway, you know. There's good things and bad things of each thing.
Yeah. out there.
Yeah, there's still a lot of messy things for sure, but you know, they're making good steps, I agree. I hate when that happens. I fucking hate when that happens. It just kind of like... There's like a frame where like it kind of does the skill, but then it doesn't. Yeah, it's still not completely fixed. It's better, but there's still a lot of wonky shit on it. He's the tiger, annoying me more than helping me. Ah, man. I was not supposed to use the tiger, but I kind of had to because I was in a bad spot. Oh. Let's see if I can avoid the aggro. No. Can't. Of course. Fucking input rip, bitch. Hey, let me just fucking stand there. Don't do anything. Give me a waste time. What actually triggers them to follow? Oh, what? This is not the right. Oh man, I missed this one. I missed this. That was on me. I just lost them. Pretty messy. Ah, cool. Yeah. Oh, I need to get on the thing. No, man. Are you kidding me? No, man, it's one of those. Should have been a sub 110 on that fight, but yeah. Got really robbed right there. I wonder, like, maybe I lost like about, I don't know, 10 minutes, something like that so far. Something like that compared to like an almost flawless run. Probably more, honestly. Or I'm just forgetting certain things. It's just really hard to get like an actual good run because of the lack of consistency with this game. There's a lot of shenanigans that can happen. And you know, being unlucky, as usual. And now we gotta wait 3 weeks for Baku kills Batman. I mean, the good thing is that after that there's upgrades for several teams for sure, including Aston Martin. That's not great. I should have just thrown the flag first. It's fine. Yeah, let's see. Time save here as well. Yeah. What the fuck are you doing? Now it's time for our wrap. Let's give it everything we got. Ready? Begin. Gratuito. Okay, it got cancelled. Amazing. Yeah, should have gone in like that. Whatever. That's my bad right there. Not doing it like that. I just opened up the fight. Se ha ido con las flechitas de los cojones, eh? Joder. Let's see if I can do this. There we go. I keep getting the thank you. Kinda slow down there a little bit. Because I kept getting like a squeeze between the fucking wall and the other thing. Okay, got a pretty bad RNG on that fight, but I managed. Final stretch. Speaking of stretch. And this track. Okay, that was a bit sketchy, but whatever. Yo, Lightning. Welcome. Remember to check out the rules. Oh, so that's not the one. I should add another split there just for the upgrade, so I don't know. Mm-hmm. What the fuck is this guy doing? Good. kidding me, man! Oh, I swear! Yeah, just fucking put the same interaction. The same button to interact with that. But to use, like, the fucking magic and everything. See anything? Yeah, fucking insane. You know, this kind of stuff that you didn't really have in Neo. Like, your interaction button was... didn't really, like... do anything else that was important besides interacting. You know? In the middle of gameplay. If only they got rid of ranged weapons, for example. Imagine if they got rid of ranged weapons, then they would have like a dedicated button for that. Anyways, let's see if I don't lose this up 2 hour run. I think I should probably like... remind me to get my chair higher after this run. Yeah, you can make a bigger shortcut in that one, but it's more risky not to. Amazing. At that point, I should have just continued and not taken the flag. But yeah. Yeah, that's another time loss. At this rate, I'm barely gonna do sub 2. As long as I start losing a shit ton of time and I get stuck on bosses or some shit like that. For some random reason. That escapes the normality. I'm gonna try doing the thing that I did the other day. Amazing! Just amazing! Wow! Wow! Insane. How are you always so lucky, Axel? Everything goes on your favor all the time. Smiley face. Ah, da porculo. I can't believe it. I'm just losing so much time right now. Just to this fucking garbage.
Yeah.
Shit. Come on. Sub 2, come on. Of course, terrible fucking start. Of course. Die. Sub 155. Oh man. Thanks for the GG, Roldemar. Thank you, Noldok, for the GG. I'm still a long way from actually good runs. At least now I have more time, but I don't know. Like, I have more time to do runs now, for like 10 days. Oh, now it's more like a week, but far too easy, yeah. I got a pretty good start, actually. It only started going badly with the alligator. I died there, then I died to the tentacle. Yeah, Strokalypse, thank you for the GG. Siren went okay. Medusa, I think I died to Medusa? I think so. Then I died a few times to the fucking clone asshole. Axe guy was okay, it was actually pretty good. Club dude. Man, I messed up one of the shots. And then I got unlucky with the pattern that they decided to do. Then I got a really good Lubu fight. Good Tautie. Planet Tiger was okay. Earth Flag was okay. Bacon was okay. War Guy was good. Black Fight. Yeah, I think I died on my way there. Yeah, I died there. Some over minute and a half, something like that. Backstab. Could have done that faster. Fireside Guy, I died like fucking three times. Two or three times against that guy. Such a good. Tempo fight was not that great. Thanks for the GG, and Lojo Lakkain. Lion's Hawk was good. A bit slow, but the first try. Tippy Flag fight, bad. I died. I died once. I made one mistake, and they took full profit of that. Preboot was good. Lubricant, I got a good fight, but it was very slow. He gave me like really slow RNG on some parts. Sneaky Flak, that was pretty slow to get. Hawk was kind of slow. It was alright. Chip and Dale was really slow. Crept was good. Could have been a bit faster. Mader was kind of slow, but not bad. Lightning Span was really slow. That asshole was really slow. And then I lost like fucking 3 minutes there. I lost like 3 minutes on that. That was so bad. Man. Then the rest was okay. Shield guy was not that great, but you know, the rest was okay. So let's see, let's think about it in minutes. So that's like 1.5 minutes, 2 minutes maybe. I stopped the music, by the way, it's not a coincidence. Yeah, that's like about 5 minutes there already. 6. Seven. 10. Yeah, it's like exactly what I said. It's around 10 minutes. On Fireside Guy, I can be 10 minutes faster on a really good run. Tempo 4 was slow. But not that slow. It's like half a minute, something like that. A minute. About 12. 13. Fourteen, 17. Yeah. Man. Like sub-140 is doable with my current route. But yeah. Okay, it's 2 a.m. I think you know what we're gonna do. First of all, I'm gonna stop recording. See ya, YouTube, by the way.